So I've got a list of scientists that I want you to talk to. You will learn a lot from these folks. I promise you, you'll think much differently about this.
You know, you're really not going to think much differently about this if you've already made up your mind and they're going to tell you what you already want to hear.
People are going to become very, very wealthy, pushing this concept of global warming down the throats of the whole country and, for that matter, the world. And that it truly is going to be used to make money, not necessarily clean up the environment.
You know, investing in green technologies is actually a wise thing to do if you want to make money. Everyone wants green and clean technology. That's what the world is changing to. Would you prefer oil and coal? Oil has devastated thousands of villages, waterways, rainforests throughout, you know, the world. And what about coal? Well, you wouldn't believe it if I told you.
There's so many factors into it. And as a matter of fact, people think the Earth is cooling in the last, I think, like 8-10 years.
Actually, researchers confirm that surface temperatures in the Northern Hemisphere were warmer over the last 10 years than any time during the last 1300.
Jesse Ventura's investigators set off to do just that. Find out if this conspiracy is real.
Yeah, don't pick up a science journal or anything. Just go straight to the few main deniers to record for your ridiculous conspiracy theory show.
Jun Sarpong travels to meet a climate scientist in the wilderness. That's where he's hiding, afraid for his life because he defied the global warming forces.
Okay, here is just where it's getting funny.
She finds a man who does not want to be seen or named.
Why the hell not? The bad guys already know who you are. Why not come out? If we're going to believe you, we need to know who you are, what your background is, so we know that you're not guilty of wrongdoing, so you could be exonerated. Or maybe you're hiding something, like your crappy background.
A climate scientist who's been at the top of his field since the 1970s, when the concern was global cooling.
So in the 1970s, the Milankovitch cycles helped prove that Earth actually goes through these long-term natural cycles and alter the climate. They also indicated that a cooling phase could begin, but it was clear that more study was needed, and virtually every single scientist now rejects that Milankovitch cooling prediction.
The attacks on me personally, I've been very concerned about the impact on my family, particularly. The stress of death threats is very traumatic.
Jeez, who are you? What did you do?
Well, my views are that global warming has occurred and climate change occurs all the time.
Ah, dude, you're fine.
The human production of CO2 is not the cause of the warming.
Maybe you're not.
So what do you think is causing global warming?
The sun. There's absolutely no question.
There's absolutely no question? I guess that's why Ventura's little investigator doesn't question this.
The sun is virtually ignored by the authorities, and particularly the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the United Nations organization, that are pushing human causes of climate change and CO2.
There is an absolute consensus in the entire science community that sunspots do not cause global warming. This guy, it might be hired by Fox. You don't know who this guy is. If you do any research, you'll clearly see that nobody believes this. In fact, everybody accepts that greenhouse gases are behind it. If I said the world was flat, then there's no more consensus that the world is round. Why do people believe hypotheses without any verification, investigation, or evidence? It's ridiculous. It's stupid.
So if global warming isn't man-made, why are they telling us it is?
Because they're using it as a vehicle for political control, control every aspect of people's lives, the number of children you can have, the number of people on the planet, where they can live, what they can drive, everything. If you can control carbon, you can control the planet.
That's just what Shepard says. Do you have any proof to go with that?
The doctor says he was bullied, shunned, and worse.
You've received death threats, your career has been stalled. Who are these people?
Well, it's a question that I ask myself and my family in our discussions ask. What's their point? Why are they trying to destroy me? All I'm trying to do is get the truth out there and get some evidence out there. And I have to come to the conclusion that I'm threatening their power, I'm threatening their funding and their money.
Again, if you want to get evidence out there, show yourself. At least give the investigator some evidence instead of the right-wing shepherd rhetoric.
There's the list. Here it is with these three people. Go out and prove it wrong.
She didn't do a very good job of proving him wrong, did she? All she did was ask questions and eat that crap up.
Meanwhile, Jesse Ventura's orders have sent Alex Piper to MIT to meet a world-renowned physicist. Jesse wants to know if the doctor in hiding has real reason to be afraid.
I personally think that global warming will turn out to be a disgrace.
So Richard Lindzen is a pretty smart guy. He's not that bad of a resource they used. But this is unbelievable. Did you know that, or rather, did the investigators know, did Jesse Ventura know, that Lindzen actually supports the basic consensus that the planet has indeed warmed significantly, and that the carbon dioxide has increased due to human activities, and that this should warm the planet? Right, they're interviewing the guy that totally believes it, that they're saying is the smartest MIT guy, and they're asking him his opinion on something else. But they don't even include the fact that he disagrees with everything else that these other guys are saying of how it's a sunspots or a cooling period.
To the scientific community and the environmental movement.
Dr. Richard Lindzen says it's true. A scientist who speaks out against global warming can expect trouble.
You have the environmental movement with this flagship. You have carbon trading, which is a trillion, multi-trillion dollar business. You have the science funding. By now, it's estimated the U.S. alone has spent something on the order of $70 billion on research.
Maybe they did have this conversation, but Ventura didn't use that information. Why did he bother leaving in all the other myths? Doesn't he want the people to know the truth? Shouldn't we get a fair and balanced amount of evidence here? $70 billion. Yeah, to try to understand the world better. Anyway, Lindzen has a opinion. It's a no big deal opinion about global warming. Some of his contentions have been reasonably contested, but also several have been proven untrue. And, he has an opinion. That's fine. Almost every other scientist disagrees, but that doesn't mean that he's right. You need more evidence than just an opinion.